subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Why DMK is dividing the people on communal line? Why Mr. Stalin is giving wishes to only for Islamic festival or Christian festival? Why he is not giving wishes to Hindu religion or Hindu people?
I am in Coimbatore, where in the Coimbatore South constituency, there's a three-way battle between the BJP, Congress and Kamal Hassan, who's from the Makkal Nidimayam. We find out how the BJP is trying to make inroads here and whether they'll be successful.
Tamil Nadu goes to polls on 6th April and the BJP is looking to open its score of zero MLAs in the state assembly for the past 20 years. Coimbatore South is where they're pinning their hopes on. We break down why. While the BJP struggles with the outsider tag in the rest of the state, in this island of hope, it seems to have an upper hand. One reason could be that the ideological partner of the Bharatiya Janata Party, which is the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, first set up its shaka in Coimbatore all the way back in 1949. RSS Coimbatore chief Raja Madurai Durai told the print that RSS Swayamsevaks had been conducting door-to-door campaigns for Vanathi Srinivasan, the BJP candidate. "We have been going to each household and telling people to vote for Vanathi," he said. "She is one of us, after all." He also said that Vanathi's husband was in the RSS, while she was a former member of the ABVP, which is a student wing of the RSS. He said, "Whoever shows proficiency in the RSS in politics, we send them to the BJP." Many people from the Coimbatore's RSS have been sent to the BJP, Durai said. He also attributed BJP's decent chance to open its account in Coimbatore South to three factors. According to him, 90% of Coimbatore is Hindu population, while 50% of the population is non-Tamil, which comprises Malayalam, Telugu and Hindi-speaking people, while he also said that since it is an MSME hub, people preferred national parties.
BJP का कार्यालय 7 साल से देखा अच्छा चल रहा है और बीजेपी को सपोर्ट हमारा रोम रोम में बीजेपी है क्योंकि बीजेपी का जो कार्यालय है ना बहुत अच्छा है बाकी कोई भी हमारे यहाँ पे इतना सपोर्ट करने वाला नहीं है बीजेपी जितना और कोई बाबू जी ने बहुत सारे काम किए क्या काम नहीं किए देखो ना देश के लिए कितने सारे काम किए वो सबको पता है रिस्क करने का सबको मालूम है पूरी दुनिया का मालूम है जो चाइना भी डरता हमको मोदी जी अच्छे लगते सबसे ज्यादा बस
आई वॉन्ट द बीजेपी टू कम टू पावर बिकॉज इन तमिलनाडु वी नीड गुड गवर्नेंस Modi should win because he's brought in very good schemes such as insurance as well as toilet facilities in villages. We know how women suffer and because of Modi's scheme, we now have more than 4 crore toilets. Congress is wiped out from India. It has below 50 seats, so there is no need to talk about them. At the center of the BJP's fight in Coimbatore South is Vanathi Srinivasan, the national president of the BJP Mahila Morcha, who is in a three-way fight against actor-politician Kamal Hassan, who formed the Makkal Nidimayam, and Congress's Mayura Jayakumar.
See, for a long time, Coimbatore and the surrounding areas are a very good organization strength is for BJP and other our Sangh Parivar organization. And even before that,
Include the RSS as well?
Yes, RSS, Hindu Munnani and other organization are also organizationally strong in this region. And even before, when Vajpayee's government was there, the two MPs from this region have represented from here. And apart from that, in 2016, when I contested here, I got 22% vote. There are a lot of scope for
development
it.
Is the main plan.
Development, we are telling, and apart from that, infrastructure. Already the local minister here, Mr. S.P. Velumani, and the sitting MLA, Mr. Amman Arjun, has taken up a lot of infrastructure projects here. Lot of flyovers, roads, and drinking water facility for each house. So, with that good image, along with our vote bank, now we could able to see the victory is visible now in this constituency. Now we have put a narrative to the Tamil Nadu people saying that we are treating all religions alike. Why DMK is dividing the people on communal line? Why Mr. Stalin is giving wishes to only for Islamic festival or Christian festival? Why he is not giving wishes to Hindu religion or Hindu people? Now the DMK is saying that no, we are 90% Hindu party like that. So the BJP would like to say the people, you treat all religion, equally. So this is what we would put to the people. Now the DMK is changing their stance of saying that no, we are not against Hindu people.
So on the charge that the BJP is a communal party, what do you have to say?
No, I don't like to see that. Even some of our district office bearers are from minority community. They are campaigning for us in those areas where the community, I mean minority people are more. Even today, we have a campaign in that area. You personally, you go, just come and see there.
Since the 1998 bomb blast, Coimbatore has witnessed communal tensions with petrol bombs being hurled at mosques and offices of Hindu outfits, as well as autos vandalized. This has also resulted in segregation of communities and creation of Muslim-majority areas. In one such area, Kottemedu, people are far from impressed with BJP. BJP is not popular, it is just an illusion. People of Tamil Nadu don't like BJP. It is a party only for people who come from North India. The BJP is not working for the common people. Vanathi Srinivasan in her campaign has videos which go viral, but her followers are only among the Hindi people and Marwadis. There is no video or campaign with our people. This is Tamil Nadu and Periyar's land. They are creating the illusion as though they are popular. When BJP contested individually, they did not get votes. In Coimbatore South constituency, we have more than 48 wards and they are hoping that BJP will gain some votes because it has allied with the AIDMK. However, the fact is that all minorities, whether Muslims, Christians, will not vote for the BJP. It is an illusion that they will get more votes this time.
District Secretary of the Tamil Muslim Munnetra Kazhagam, Mujib Rahman, said BJP was a party that separated people by religion and language. The TMMK was a party that was started in 1995 to work for the rights of oppressed people, he said. In Coimbatore, the Tamil Muslim Munnetra Kazhagam had about 40,000 members and lots of supporters. It was campaigning for the Congress candidate up against Vanathi Mayura Jayakumar. We raise our voice for social justice and gather people who are against the BJP. We are trying to get people to cast their vote for the Secular Progressive Alliance to vote for Congress's Mayura Jayakumar. In Tamil Nadu, Muslim organizations and parties are strong. Here, this is the land of social justice and has a strong Dravidian ideology, so there is no way for the BJP to do indecent things. But now it is trying to rule Tamil Nadu through the AIADMK.
Expecting the AIADMK votes to get transferred with the BJP here is confident of winning the Coimbatore South constituency and its candidate Vanathi Srinivasan emerging victorious. However, the opposition parties say that the BJP is still an outsider party and that they're only campaigning in front of the Hindi-speaking population here in Coimbatore. One will have to wait till see till 2nd May what the results say. For The Print, this is Revati Krishnan reporting from Coimbatore.